common mistakes that pastors make. In every church, there are three groups of people. There are the there's the critics, and that's the smallest group.
Okay.
Then there is the uncommitted, and that's the largest group.
Okay.
And then there's the committed, which is the medium-sized group. Now, the average pastor, when he goes to church on Sunday, he preaches at the critics. He focuses his whole message. That whole week he's been studying to get them told, and that's what he does. Well, what is he doing? He's really creating an atmosphere that he really doesn't want, because death and life is in the power of the tongue. Well, all the uncommitted here is nobody does anything here.
Wow.
Nobody gives, nobody comes, and that's all they hear. That's all they hear. Well, and so the committed group is left unfed.
Wow.
And so what happens is there's this subtle migration of the uncommitted over to the critics.
Wow.
Because that's all they've heard.
Yeah.
So what the pastor has to do, he has to use the discipline that when he goes to church on Sunday, he's going to go with the goer. So he's going to feed this group, the committed group.
Yes, sir.
And he's going to speak life to this group. Watch this. And when he does, the uncommitted will hear. People obey God here.
I got it, yeah.
People give here. People follow leadership here, and you'll have that migration, and that group will grow. But now the critics now, since they have been given no life, guess what happens?
Yes, sir.
They diminish, and their voice really is silenced.
So you got to feed the committed and starve the critics.
You got to do that.
Wow.